Well, praise the Lord, everybody. Good morning, good morning, good morning. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in our mouth. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. There is no God like our God. There is no God as high as our God. There is no God as great as our God. There is no God as awesome as our God. He is worthy to be praised. So we want to say welcome. You have reached the live service emanating from the sanctuary of the New Covenant Sea Church here in the Ingleside community of Port Gibson, Mississippi, 7058 Carnac Ferry Road. So we're going to ask you as you come in this morning, we're so elated and excited that you chose to worship with us. You know, now you don't have to walk. You just one click away. So we want you to stay on for the next 55 to 60 minutes with us. That's all we're going to be on. We're going to spend time worshiping the Lord together. We're going to spend time fellowshipping around the communion table, and then we're going to get a good word. So why don't you take the time to do what we normally do? We call virtual evangelism. Those in the sanctuary, take out your phone, and let's invite at least 5 people to the broadcast this morning. Invite at least 5 people to the broadcast in Jesus' name. We are so glad that you are on live with us this morning. I believe God has a blessing with your name on it. If you're in need of healing, you can receive your healing this morning, your breakthrough, whatever's going on in your life. God can meet your needs. We are a church that believes and teach the word of God. If it says it's black, it's black. If it says it's white, it's white. And if the word says you're healed, then you are healed. You just got to access it by faith. Amen. So glad to have all of you on. I want to acknowledge my cousin Hope Bolton, who's always on with us almost every Sunday. Cuz, I'm not ignoring you on purpose, but thank you for joining with us. Come on and invite some other people from our hometown, Bay Springs, Mississippi. Glory to God. We want you to get your Bible, get your notebook. Let's get ready to worship God. Let's get ready to hear from God this morning in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I want you to know that Jesus is Lord. That means he rules and he's right. There is no power higher than God's power. There's no power higher than the name of Jesus. There's no political party. There is no race higher than Jesus. Jesus is Lord. I'm so glad I know there is no God bigger than our God, no God greater than our God. Our God is worthy to be praised. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So why don't you stand right there with us? Amen. I see you with your hair rollers in your hair, so forth and so on. Why don't you stand with us and let's worship the Lord together this morning in Jesus' name. Let's declare that our God reigns. How many of you know that our God reigns? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord.
Come on, put your hands together.
Come on, put your hands together. Somebody shout hallelujah. Come on, let's declare it together. Glory to God. Let's sing, our God reigns. Our God reigns. Lord, you reign above every name. Oh, our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
Our God reigns. Lord, you reign above every name. With power. With power.
Dominion, authority, you reign.
With power and majesty. Dominion, authority. With power.
Let's sing
it and take it up. Our God reigns.
Our God reigns.
lift your hands in his presence. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Come on, open your mouth and begin to worship him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you. We glorify you. We magnify you. We glorify your name, Jesus. We exalt you. Hallelujah. We glorify your name. Hallelujah. You are worthy of praise, worthy of glory. Come on, praise is the fruit of your lips. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. We exalt you. Hallelujah. We magnify you. Receive our worship. Receive our praise. Hallelujah. Let it flow in you this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We magnify you, Jesus. We lift you up over the state of Mississippi. We lift you up over unemployment. We lift you up over strife. We lift you up over relationship issues. We lift you up this morning. Come on, help me lift him up. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We lift you up, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, this is one we know in New Convincing Church. Can we sing together? Flow to you.
River of
sanctuary, just lift your hands. We'll give it to you. We'll serve you in Jesus' name. Go ahead and get your crackers, your light bread, your grape juice. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We give you glory. We give you honor. Lord, we thank you for this time of communion. We thank you for this time of sharing over the communion table. We thank you for the power of God that is released over this time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I want you to understand this is not a second Sunday ritual. This is not some type of religion, but this has to do with relationship. When we understand the power that is released over the communion table, we'll take it serious. And the Bible says, as often as you do it in remembrance of me. Well, Pastor, I got this going on. I got that going on, so I'm not going to take it. No, if you got sin in your life, you need to get it right over the communion table. There's no such thing. We've been taught a lot of religion. You know, if you got all in your heart, you got to go back and apologize to somebody before communion. Well, if you were like me, we only had communion once a quarter. So you mean to tell me you can wait a whole quarter with unforgiveness in your heart? The moment you realize you got unforgiveness, you need to forgive right then. All are welcome at the communion table. What is the prerequisite for receiving communion? Have you met Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior? That's all the only biblical requirement that we have. So, 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23. It says, "For I have received of the Lord that which also I delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night which he was betrayed, he took bread." Bread. Notice, when Jesus was going through betrayal, he didn't get on Facebook and attack the folk. He went and did, he connected to the power source. So when he was betrayed, the Bible says, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said it. So right now, Father, in Jesus' name, we come before you today as a corporate body, online and in person. And we come to receive this communion right now. And Father, we thank you for Jesus Christ. We thank you for the price that he paid and the sacrifice that he made. He took on our unrighteousness and gave us his righteousness. He took on our sickness and gave us his healing. He took on our depression and our oppression, and he gave us his joy, righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That is the kingdom of God. And so there is no situation that was not dealt with on the cross. But Lord, we thank you that Jesus didn't stay on the cross and he didn't stay in the grave. We thank you that on the third day, he arose declaring victory over everything that would bind us. And we are partakers of that victory. And so, Father, we thank you that now that we're saved, we are no longer victims. We are victors in Jesus Christ. Doesn't matter how we feel, doesn't matter how it looks, your word says it and we believe it. So as we partake this morning, we partake of our victory. We partake of our victory in our marriage. We partake of our victory in our body. And I speak to every COVID-19 patient, be healed in Jesus' name. It belongs to you, and you don't have to have COVID. Not another day, you can receive your healing this morning. So in Jesus' name, if you'll take the bread, which represents the body of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Jesus' body was broken, so you don't have to be broken in any area. You don't have to be broken in your emotions. You don't have to be broken in your relationships. You don't have to be broken in your career. You don't have to be broken in your finances. You don't have to be broke another day in your life. Thank God that Jesus gave us a way out. You may partake. Well, Pastor Cooley, how do I know that I'm going to receive the promises of God? I have been good enough. I haven't done everything right. It's not about you. It's about what Jesus Christ has done. Is obedience important? Absolutely. But thank God, if it was just based solely on our obedience, you and I would be out of luck. God is so gracious, and he loves us so much. Amen. There were times when I know I didn't. did not deserve the blessings of God based on what I did. And because of his grace, his unmerited favor, and his mercy, he blessed me anyway. And I'm here to tell you this morning, don't let condemnation steal from you what's rightfully yours. Come out of guilt, come out of shame, come out of condemnation, and receive what's yours in Jesus' name. So we thank you, Father, for the blood of Jesus Christ that cleanses us from our sin and heals us of every sickness and every disease. And we receive it right now by faith. You may partake. And so we declare all is well.
All is well.
All is well.
All
is well. All is well. Come on, say it. Come on, type it in. Type in all is well.
All is well.
All is well in Jesus' name. Well, you may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Go ahead and take out your Bible. Amen. Let's get ready for the Word of God. We're so happy that you all have joined us on this Sunday morning. We are grateful. I know some of you are getting ready for you're getting ready for the great snow blizzard we get ready to have. But I stopped by Kroger on my way in early this morning, and man, the parking lot was packed. I was like, what are all these people doing at Kroger? And some say they're getting ready for the apocalypse, the snowpocalypse. In other words, all this big snow we get ready to have now. I don't know if it's going to snow or not, but hey, all is well. And we're so glad again to have you join with us. If you're just joining with us, why don't you consider sharing this with someone? We are a church that preaches and teaches the Word of God, and we teach it with simplicity and practicality so it can be applied to your everyday life in an effective and a practical manner, thereby becoming world changers, changing your immediate world and all those you come in contact with. Come on and type in the word better this morning. I don't care what somebody has said. I don't care what it looks like. Everything about your life is getting better. Your relationship, better. Your finances, better. Your children, better. Your mindset, better. Your health, better. You're not at the end of your rope. It's not over for you. I don't care what they say. I don't care who has called you out, who has said that you're just no more good. I stop by to tell you some good news. God has spoken that over you. And if God has said, whatever they said really doesn't matter. It only matters if you choose to believe it. And I choose to believe the word of God. Can somebody shout amen?
Amen.
Now go to Psalms 91. Psalms 91. I'm starting to see this, what you see me doing when I'm bending over. Starting to see I'm not taking a sip out of my cup. Praise God. Psalms 91. Let me make sure it's going here. Psalms 91. And I want to be obedient to the Lord. I want to deal with this issue of COVID-19. Now, there are people who say everybody's going to get it. That ain't nowhere in the scripture. And it's only going to happen to you if you believe it. Now, I'm not doubting anybody who has gotten who's experienced COVID-19. That's not what I'm saying. But here's what I am saying to you, child of God, and those of you who are watching me online. Listen, COVID-19, you don't have to have it. Okay? Now, what opens the door? Fear. Everything that is good is God. Everything that is bad is the devil. Somebody type that in. Somebody write that in. Those of you in the sanctuary, if you're taking notes, type it right down. Everything that is good is God. Everything that is bad is of the devil. Satan's method of Satan's method of operation is to operate off of fear. You got to remember that Lucifer was an archangel who was in heaven at one time. So he knows how the kingdom of God works. The kingdom of God works off of a principle of seed, time, and harvest. So, you sow a seed in your heart in the ground, and over time, as you meditate on that, as you ponder it, guess what? It's going to grow up in your life. And so, fear is the direct opposite of faith. Somebody type that in. Fear is the opposite of faith. Fear is the
faith of the devil. Fear is the faith of the devil. Now, as believers, we walk by faith in the true and the living God, Jehovah God. But unless you have scripture, you are not in faith. Well, Pastor, you know God ain't gonna put no more on you than you can bear. That is not in the Bible. I know I'm gonna shake some of you up. There is no scripture in the Bible that says God will not put more on you than you can bear. There is a scripture in 1 Corinthians that says there has no temptation overtaking you such as is common to man, but God is faithful who will not allow you to be tempted above that you are able. For with the temptation, he will also make a way of escape. But stop, we got to stop saying stuff that's not biblical, okay? There is no scripture in the Bible. Child, God ain't gonna put no more on you than you can bear. God doesn't put bad stuff on his people to teach them a lesson. That's erroneous, unbiblical, unsound, lying teaching. And it is of the enemy, it's of the devil. We gotta stick with the word. Pastor, what scripture did you just quote? 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. That's what I just quoted for you. Read it for yourself. But there is no scripture. I will give you $1,000 if you can show me and tell me a scripture that says God won't put no more on you than you can bear. It's not Bible and it's a lie. Now go to Psalms 91. Psalms 91. Pastor, I thought you were talking about restoration. I am, but I got to give you these instructions. I'm a pastor first, so I got to give you some instructions. Now, first and foremost, point number one in this pre-sermon. You know, like the pre-anniversary is the pre-sermon. Point number one, COVID-19 is not from God.
Amen.
God didn't start it. Hallelujah, but he can't stop it.
Amen.
But he did not start it. Number two, some people believe that when the calendar year changed, that COVID-19 was just going to automatically disappear. I got news for you. It's not. It's going to take time for COVID-19 to get out of the earth. Okay? It's going to take time. It has to run its course. We believe God for the vaccine. Now the vaccine is here. Now we got to get people vaccinated. Okay? We got to get things done. So it's going to take time. Okay? Even though the calendar year changed, the season that we were in 2020, we are still in that season now, but that doesn't have to affect you when you learn to walk by faith.
Amen.
Somebody say walk by faith.
Walk by faith.
So I want to give it to you straight with no chaser, and I come in peace. But COVID-19 is not just going to vanish away. It's going to take time. But because COVID-19 is in the earth, does not mean you and I as believers have to receive it. Now, there's the natural side for us, and then there's a spiritual side. The natural side are these things. Wear your mask. Socially distant. That means even from some of your family members, because you don't know where they've been.
Amen.
Wash your hands. Wear your mask. Do what you know to do in the natural. Take elderberry. Take ginger root. Take echinacea. Take zinc. Take elderberry. You got to take these things to build up your immune system. If you have diabetes or high blood pressure, your immune system, or cancer or lupus or anything, any autoimmune disease, your immune system is already compromised in the natural. But the word says by Jesus Christ, you are already healed, but that doesn't mean you go out and do something stupid. Now, Psalms 91. Now, I dealt with the natural. Now, let's talk about the spiritual. Because we got some weirdos out there saying, oh, if you ain't got your church open, you ain't in faith. That's the biggest lie I've been told. God is not going to have you come somewhere in faith and then people wind up dying. That's foolishness. Everybody under the sound of my voice needs to read Apostle Frederick Casey Price's book, Faith, Foolishness, or Presumption. A lot of stuff we say that faith is not really faith at all. It's foolishness.
Amen.
Okay? Now, let me speak to my pastors, brothers, sisters, I love you. But what you have to do, the Lord told me to tell you, you got to get on your face and find out what God wants for your congregation. You can no longer operate under the copycat ministry. Because when you operate under the copycat ministry, there's no anointing on what you're doing. If a man or woman is doing something that's anointed, you're not going to have the same result just because you do what they did. You got to hear from God for yourself, and you got to find out what God wants for your congregation. You can't just open up because you come and see churches open. You can't do what I do or anybody else. You got to hear from God for yourself. Type in, hear from God for yourself. So, pastor, the day is over when you can just get up and shout to folk and a little dabadoonia, and I'm preaching sermons you've not rehearsed for 30 years, like this dry bone sermon. They've been preaching that sermon since I was a little boy. I'm 47 years old. There's no revelation in that. Okay?
Hallelujah.
So are you listening to me? And I love you, but I'm going to tell you the truth. You got to get on your face and seek God. Because, let's look at the situation. Some of you say, some of you pastors, and some of you who sit on the pastors, say, I ain't going to open back up to the new year. The new year is here, and now the COVID cases are higher. I got my fact checker back there. They're higher than they were before the pandemic first started. Am I right?
Correct.
They're much higher now. Okay? So you got to hear from God for you and your congregation, and you got to listen to your congregation. You can't force people to come back to church. If they don't want to come, they're not coming. But they got to trust you and trust that you're hearing from God. All right, Psalm 91. It matters where you go to church. It matters who your pastor is. Where you go to church is a matter of life or death. Psalm 91. Why do you say that? Because Proverbs 28 says death and life is in the power. I'm sorry, Proverbs 18. Death and life is in the power of the tongue. Your pastor, who you sit under, is either ministering life to you or they're ministering death to you.
Amen.
Okay? Psalm 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And every one of you need a pastor. There is no bastard children. There shouldn't be no bastard children in the kingdom of God. Did you hear what I said?
Right.
You need to get under a pastor and submit to their leadership. And if you're in a church, including this one, and you can't trust me and my wife, we'll send you where you can trust somebody else. Okay? Well, I'm not in it for no members. I'm here to minister to the needs of people. And if you're in ministry for any other reason, shut it down.
Amen.
All right. Ministry is all about people and loving the people, meeting the needs of the people. It's not about me sitting up in a big chair like I'm the king. I hate them chairs, them ugly chairs, them big chairs. They got big chairs for the preacher. No, the Bible says the common people heard Jesus gladly. It's not the Eric Coolman show. We're here to make Jesus famous. To let the world know Jesus is still a healer, he's still a deliverer, and he's still a filler with the Holy Ghost. And whatever you got going wrong in your life, whatever's broken, Jesus Christ can fix it. And if we're doing it for any other reason, shut it down. In this season, your gimmicks, your playing games, your prophesying, your prophesying, your laying folk out in the floor will not work in this season.
Hallelujah.
That it's time for the genuine and the authentic presence and power of God. People are tired of playing church. Now, I love to have fun, but when it comes to this, I am not playing. This is not a joke. This is not some side gig for me. Glory to God. I'm not in it for the money. I'm in it for the soul. And I have a heart for people. And if you don't have a heart for people, you're not called to operate in ministry.
Amen.
Psalm 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in whom will I trust. God is your fortress. So when they build a fortress, military folk, you build a fortress so that nothing can come in and nothing can go out. Am I talking right? So if God is your fortress, COVID-19 can't get in unless you got a crack. And that crack is fear. Now, the Lord told me specifically in our church, you're hearing me teach faith, but some of you are full of fear. Well, pastor, I'm just doing it. I've got common sense. Yeah, you got common sense, but if you really check your heart, there's fear in there. And wherever there's fear, faith cannot work in a heart full of fear.
Amen.
How do I get fear out? You got to fill your heart up with the word, fill it up with faith. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
All right, now it says, surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. The word of God is the truth. This is not facts. This is not a white man's book. This is not the white man's book to brainwash the blacks. No, this is the B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand on the word of God. The B-I-B-L-E. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Now, it says, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day. Now, let me tell you where a lot of you are missing it. You know the word up here. You mentally ascend to it, but the word is not in your heart or in your spirit. I'm not talking about the thing that pumped blood. I'm talking about the real you. It's not there because you know the word up here don't mean it's going to work for you. How am I going to get the word to work for me? Joshua 1 and 8. This book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but in it you shall meditate day and night. In order to get this word down on the inside of you, you got to meditate this word. Well, Pastor, how do you meditate? If you know how to worry, you know how to meditate. In other words, worry is negative meditation. So what I do with this word, I get this scripture, Psalms 91, and it said, thou shalt not be afraid, I meditate that. I write that scripture down. I put it on the refrigerator. I say it out of my mouth. The word of God has to be in two places in order for it to work in your life. I'm practical. I ain't about religion, I'm practical. It got to be in two places. It got to be it coming out of your mouth and into your heart. You got to hear yourself say what God says. Oh, I'm preaching better, you shout. Somebody say glory to God. So it said, thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that walketh at noonday. 1,000 shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. You got to put this word on your mouth. COVID-19 will not come nigh my dwelling. Okay? You got to put it. Now, when you say that, the enemy's going to attack. Right now, there's some things that may have been going on in your life, and the reason that's been going on, let me give you an example. Let me give you an example. If I teach on him, I'm going to help about 12 of you right now. If I, and I'm not no pastor, and I teach on healing, know that that's where the enemy is going to attack the church. Did you hear what I just said? Well, if I teach on finances, and your finances coming in abundance, you're going to start having attacks out of everywhere.
Amen.
Why? Because the enemy does not want their word to take root in your heart, and he wants to show you or try to convince you that what I'm preaching won't work.
Amen.
The reason he fights it so is because he knows it works. Hallelujah to God. And the reason religious people fight us so is because they don't want the word preached, because it exposes what they've been doing. Hallelujah to God. But I'm on assignment from Jehovah God, and I will not stop, and you can't stop me. Hallelujah to God. So, I'm going to say it again, and some of you don't catch it. When I teach on healing, expect the attacks to come in your physical body. Why? Because the enemy is working overtime to get the word out of your life. If I start teaching on relationship, expect relationships to start being attacked. Why? Because Satan's going to try to convince you that stuff ain't working. That pastor tell a lie. Him and his wife ain't happy. They just putting on a front. Let me tell you something, me and everybody is real as you can get. We don't put on a front. We don't, after a while, I'm going to forget I'm pretending. You know what I'm saying? We are not them preachers that get up and sit up in the pulpit. And my wife sit up with a big hat on and gloves up to here. We the real deal Holyfield. Right. What you see is what you get. And we tell y'all all the time, we are not perfect. We have intense fellowship just like you. Right. But we just choose to not allow that intense fellowship to get us out of love. The number one problem in marriage is selfishness.
All right.
Speak, pastor. I'm preaching, you shout.
Hallelujah.
All right, let's keep going. So, in verse 6 said, no pestilence. Well, that walking, you ain't got to be afraid of none of those things. But you got to get that down on the inside of you. How do you know when it get down on the inside of you? Because sometimes, have you ever heard a song and you ain't thinking about it? And you'll wake up the next morning singing that song. It's like you can hear it down in here. That's because you spent time with that word and you squeezed the juice out of it by meditating the word. You got to be a steward over your mind on purpose. How do you control your thoughts? By replacing them with opposite thoughts. I used to think when I first got saved, you can't control your thoughts. Let's do this exercise. We've done it before. I want you to think of a big, gray, and black zebra stripe elephant. Think about that in your mind. I want you to think about it. Get a picture. I want you to start counting to 10 in your head. Go. And I say out loud, I say count in your head. Say your name. Out loud. Say your name. What happened when you said your name? You're right. All that, what I told you, the elephant and the counting, it stopped. Your mind has to shut down for your mouth to speak. I'm trying to help you get out of that hole you in. There is power in your mouth. And you control your thoughts by what you look at, what you listen to, and what you let come out of your mouth. Amen, somebody. You get full of porn, you're going to be full of lust. Say amen, somebody. You go to the strip club, you're going to be full of lust. You get full of the news, you're going to be full of fear. I didn't tell you don't watch the news, but you know where you are. I can't watch all that all the time because it starts working on my heart. And when I get watch the news, sometimes I got to get the word immediately to flush out that crap that I haven't heard. The world's news gives you facts, but the word of God gives you the truth. And truth, check this out, and I ain't trying to be funny, truth trumps facts.
All right,
Pastor. I said truth trumps facts.
Go ahead, Pastor.
Hallelujah to God.
Hallelujah.
So, here's my point. And then I'm going to go to today's message. But Pastor, we got to be through in a minute. I'm going to be through. Because I know how to flow with the Holy Ghost. And not that I'm any better. But here's this. It says, there shall no evil befall thee, verse 10, neither shall any plague come nigh your dwelling. That is your faith that you don't have to have COVID-19. It don't have to come to your house. Everybody will eventually get it. That's a lie from the pit of hell. I don't receive it. I'm doing what I'm supposed to do in the natural. And I trust God in the spirit.
Amen.
So, the Bible said you don't have to have a plague come down you. You don't have to be have a plague. Now, here's the thing. I'm going to deal with it. You have people who say they're afraid of COVID, but they're all out at the store shopping, but you say I'm about to come to church. I can't come to church because I'm scared I'm going to get COVID. You are more apt to get it out there in all them stores with all them folk you don't know than you are in a church that's set up to operate and do things the right way based on the CDC guidelines. Excellence demands respect.
Mm-hmm.
And when you're a church of excellence, you don't do stuff sloppy. If you say 10 a.m., you mean 10 a.m. That don't mean come in at 10:12. Now again, listen, I'm preaching, but you gotta let the Lord talk to you. I ain't getting on you because you was late for church. That ain't what I'm saying. But I'm saying if you got excellence starts with a mindset. And if you keep hanging around folk who got low-level thinking, say 10 o'clock and come at 10:15, that's okay. It's not okay. Okay? You got to operate in excellence. That means you got to do things at top notch.
Yes.
Amen. The church of the Lord Jesus Christ shouldn't be ragged.
Yes.
We should just throw stuff up and expect God to bless it.
Amen.
God is not going to bless your mess.
Amen.
So, rest, release, faith. Come on, lift your hand up and say this.
Father,
I dwell
in
the secret place
of the Most High
God.
And
I abide
under the shadow
of the Almighty. I say of you,
you
are my refuge.
You are my
fortress.
You are my
God.
And in
you
will I
trust.
Surely,
you
will deliver
me
from the snare
of the devil
and
from the
noisome
pestilence.
You
cover me
with
your feathers
and
under your
wings.
I shall
trust.
Your
truth,
the word of
God,
is my
shield
and
my buckler.
I will not
be afraid
for the
terror
by night,
nor
for the
arrow
that
fly
by day,
nor
for COVID-19
that
walketh in
darkness.
A thousand
shall fall
at my
side,
and
10,000
at my
right
hand,
but
COVID-19
shall not
come
down me.
Let's keep
going.
Come on,
keep your hands
up.
Keep
your hands up. Come on,
I'm
teaching you how to
speak
the word of
God.
Come on,
say this.
There shall
no
evil
befall
me,
neither
shall
any
plague
or
virus,
COVID-19,
or
flu,
or
any
virus
will
come down
my
dwelling.
With
long
life
will
he
satisfy
me
and
show
me
his
salvation.
Amen?
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 Amen.
Now,
5 minutes
and I'm
done.
Y'all ready?
Hallelujah.
5 minutes
and I'm done.
Go to
Joel chapter
2.
It's
restoration
time
right now.
But
you
gotta know,
everything
that is
good,
God
did.
Everything
that is
bad,
the
devil did.
Period.
Okay?
Everything
that's
good,
God
does it.
Everything
that's
bad,
the
devil did.
We
got to
change
our
thinking
to line
up
with
the word
of God.
Amen.
Joel
chapter 2.
Restoration
is here
now.
Now,
let me
give you
3
things
quickly
that's
going to be
restored
to you
this
year.
Amen.
Now,
yes,
let
me make
it clear.
There's
still going to
be
trouble
in
the world.
We're
still going to
have
trouble
in
the
politics.
I'm not speaking
down
on my belief.
I want
you
to get
an
understanding.
Use
some
wisdom.
COVID-19
is
not
just
going to
disappear.
The
problems in
our
government
is not
just
going to,
you know,
all of
a
sudden
change.
It's
going to
take some
time
for
those
things
to work
out.
But
what
will
help
it
to
speed
up
the
process
is
our
intercessory
prayer.
If
you
haven't
been filled
with
the Holy
Ghost,
with
the
Bible
evidence
of speaking
in
other
tongues,
you need
to
be
filled
with
the Holy
Ghost
today,
because
that's
the
only
way
you're going
to know
how
to
pray
effectively.
There's
only
so
much
you
can pray
in
the natural.
But
when
you
pray
in
the Holy
Ghost
helps
you
to
pray
as
you
are
praying.
Well,
Pastor,
I don't
know
how
to pray.
No,
you
ain't
doing
it on
your own.
The Holy
Ghost
on
the
inside
of you
is
helping
you
to pray.
It's
not
a
language
you
learn.
It's
a
supernatural
language.
That's
not
have
nothing
to do
with
your
mindset.
And
it
will
get
the
job
done.
That's
why
the
devil
fights
it
so.
Amen?
Amen.
Now,
Joel
chapter
2.
So,
number
1,
let
me
give
you
clearly
what
God
is
going
to
restore.
He's
going
to restore
your
health
to
you.
He's
going to
restore
your
health
to
you.
Thank
you,
Lord.
Somebody
say,
thank
you,
Lord.
Thank
you,
Lord.
He's
going
to
restore
your
health
to
you.
Sure
is.
Hallelujah.
Thank
you, Lord.
Now, you
got to
cooperate
with
God,
because
some of
you
got to
get
off
that
couch.
Some of
you,
including
me,
got to
stop
eating all
them
sweets.
And
some
of us
got
to learn
to
do
some
type
of
exercise.
Yeah.
Okay?
Number
2,
God
is going to
restore
your
joy.
Some
of you
have
allowed
COVID-19
and
tests
and
trials
and
tribulations
to
steal
your
joy.
But
this
year
is
a
year
of
restoration
for
you.
Now
listen,
what
I am
preaching Even though I'm reaching the world, I'm speaking specifically to the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. It's going to get darker and darker in the world. But there's going to be light, Sister Rhonda, in the church. We are supposed to be the bright light shining in the midst of darkness. Yes, you can have joy in the midst of this pandemic. Yes, you can prosper. Your business can grow during this pandemic. I got people who are sitting here right now who is happening for them so fast they're getting checks all the time.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Glory.
God is going to restore your joy. And number three, God is going to restore your identity. Let me say this to you. Thank God I'm African American. I'm proud to be African American. But that does not make me who I am in the kingdom. What makes you who you are in the kingdom is your identity in Jesus Christ. And I want to apologize to all those of you who are watching because the church has did a blank poor job. You fill in the blank. The church has done a blank poor job of teaching you about your identity.
Amen.
We've done a bad, terrible job. But guess what? In this year, if you don't know who you are and you come to this church and you watch this live, it ain't going to be because I ain't teaching.
Come on now.
Say amen. So, three things. Your health, say my health.
My health.
My joy. And
my identity.
He's also going to restore relationships. I'm a living witness. The Lord started restoring relationships, broken relationships in my wife and I at the end of last year.
Hallelujah.
And what has been broken, if you allow it, God will restore it. All right, I got to hurry up. Here we go. Joel chapter 2. I don't have time to read all that today. I want to get to the crux of the matter. Verse 25. And I will restore to you the years.
Hallelujah.
The years.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
The years. Somebody type in years. The years. That the devourer. The canker worm and the palm worm and all that represents the devourer. The devourer is led by Satan. Satan is the devourer. And everything that was stolen from you, the Lord God, Jehovah Gomorrah, is going to restore. Jehovah Gomorrah is God's name, and that name means recompense. That name means the payback. And the Lord told me to tell you this morning that this is your year of a big payback.
Thank you, Lord.
I said, this is your year of a big payback. All the hurt you've been going through, all the hell you've gone through, it is payback time. Glory to God. But now, let me say this. It's going to be payback time for you because you're going to pray for somebody else to get their restoration.
Amen. Amen.
There is a principle in the kingdom of God that says what you do for somebody else, God will make happen for you.
Amen.
That means doing this building project that we got going on, that while we're building, we're going to be sowing it to somebody else who's doing the same thing we're doing.
Hallelujah.
That's getting the results. Now, I ain't just talking about just bucket plucking up. Just so no, we're going to sow in some anointed ground.
Yeah.
The reason some of you are not prospering because you're planting seeds in places that's not anointed. Where there is no anointing, guess what? There's going to be famine and there's going to be lack. But I'll stop by to tell you this morning that in the kingdom of God, where the anointing is, there is no lack and there is no shortage. Hallelujah to God. I feel my Holy Ghost help, Brother Clark. I feel my materials going on.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God is in a restoration business. Hallelujah to God. So I'll preach this restoration till you start experiencing it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He is Jehovah the Lord. Now, we name our children stuff because it's cute. In biblical times, names were given to identify what a person would do, their character, and how they would respond. That's why God's name is Jehovah Gomorrah. If it's not, it's all in his name. His name tells you what he will do, how he will do it, and why he will do it. Because he is Jehovah. Come on, he is the God of recompense. Now, vengeance from God has nothing to do with hate. So you can't be operating in strife. And you can't not be operating. Some of you mean as a junkyard dog. And the reason you are not getting the blessing of God because you're so mean and ignorant. Well, that just means, no, God is saying he's tired of you.
Amen.
Your problem is you and he's tired of you.
Amen.
Get me out the way and let God do what he needs to do in your life.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah to God.
Yes,
last scripture and I'm done.
Yes.
Hallelujah to God.
Hallelujah.
Ooh, Holy Ghost, where you want me to go? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. Go to Job 42. We'll pick up here next Sunday. Job 42. Job is right before Psalms. Now, Job was a candidate for restoration. I told you that God will restore. Okay? I'm going to give you a biblical example in the Old Testament as well as the New Testament of the restoration of Almighty God. Don't click off yet. I'm almost done. What does the word restore mean? In the Hebrew, it means to give back what was lost or stolen, to recompense or to pay back. You ought to type in, it's time for the big payback. I'm trying to tell you it's time for the big payback. The Bible says when the thief is caught, he must repay sevenfold. And I stop by to tell you who the thief is. The thief is not the Republican Party. The thief is not the Democratic Party. The thief is not President Trump. The thief is Satan, Diablo, Beelzebub, Lucifer. He's the ragged head thief, glory to God. But he is defeated. And the only reason that you are not walking in victory over him because you think he got more power than you. So restore, to give back what was lost or stolen, to recompense, to pay back. Now, also the word restore means shalom. In the Hebrew, it means to make whole or good or to make compensation. God saying, I'm going to let shalom visit your house. Shalom means nothing missing, nothing broken, and nothing lacking. Say that, nothing missing,
nothing
broken, and nothing
lacking.
Now, why will God do that for you so that you can do what God did for you for somebody else? But here's the thing. You can't do it for folk just because they're your family. You got to do it for folk because that's what God said.
All right.
And the reason some of us don't have money, because we won't let our family swindle us out of it all. Because they're trying to give to the house. What did they do before you won the lottery? What did they do before you got that settlement? But you got, when you got get money in your life, you got to be a barefooted priest and listen to what God is telling you to do. And whatever he don't tell you to do, don't do it. Every need is not a call. Sometimes we try to play God for people that God ain't even playing God for.
All right. Come on now.
People are where they are because of, there is a reason for why people are where they are.
All right.
Come on, sister. Now, let me show you what happened to Job when I'm done. Job 42, verse 10. And the Lord turned the captivity of Job when he prayed for his friends. Also, the Lord gave Job twice as much as he had before. Next Sunday, I'm going to talk about the double. The Lord said you're going to have double for your shame. They have tried to shame you on your job. Your family has tried to shame you. The people in your neighborhood have tried to shame you. But this is your year of the double. Whatever you know, the Bible said I'm going to give you double. I'm going to give you twice as much. Glory to God. Somebody say hallelujah. Come on and give the Lord a hand clap for praise. Hallelujah. I love what I do to the glory of God, my Father. Hallelujah. And I want to guess what? We're going to see the testimony. But here's what the Lord is saying to a New Covenant City Church family. He needs you to walk this year consistent. Be consistent in your tithe. Be consistent in your prayer. Be consistent in your coming to church. Or joining online. Consistency is your key to the breakthrough. Now, your consistency is going to be tested. Because there's going to be times where it don't look like you're going to have enough to tithe. There's going to be times when you don't feel like coming to church. There's going to gonna be times when you don't feel like doing right. But we don't live by our feelings because our feelings are a poor choice to base our life on. Why? Because your feelings are inconsistent. But when you go with the truth of the Word of God, you can't lose. Come on, bow your head. Come on, give God glory. Come on, give God praise. Come on and magnify that. Come on and thank you for the words you heard today. Hallelujah, glory to God. Thank you that He brought you out of darkness. He brought you out of that dead church. He brought you out of that unbelieving church. Little church that don't teach you the Word of God. Lord, we give you praise. We give you glory. We thank you for your Word, God. We thank you for understanding. We thank you for revelation, God. We thank you for healing this morning. In Jesus' name. Now, Lord, we pray for every person that has been diagnosed with COVID-19. Lord, we pray in the Holy Ghost right now. We speak forth their healing in Jesus' name. We declare they will live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. With long life will you satisfy them and show them your salvation. So we speak healing in their lungs. We speak, Father, that we thank you that their lungs are elastic. They're flowing and pumping like they're supposed to flow and pump in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Everything in their nasal passage is being healed. And we thank you that the blood of Jesus is driving out COVID-19. In Jesus' name. We pray for every family that has lost someone to COVID-19, God. We thank you, first of all, dear brother, you didn't take that loved one. You didn't kill that relative. That the devil can't just steal, kill, and destroy. But you came with your life. And life more abundantly. Father, we speak restoration, God. In Jesus' name, we call them out of depression. Out of all pressure in Jesus' name. Be healed, be delivered, and be set free. You got to say, I take it in Jesus' name. I take it in Jesus' name. I'm not going to put up with this or nothing. You got to become aggressive about what you want from God. Now, are you saved? The most important thing to us, I'm after souls. I'm not after church members. I'm after souls. I don't care what church you go to. I want to know are you part of the kingdom. And let me tell you something. What you being a member of the church don't mean you're saved. You being saved don't mean you're going to live a perfect life. You being saved means that, guess what? I now am imperfect and I made a perfect Jesus. And I'm going to develop and grow and mature in the things of God. So my brother, my sister, stop putting it off. Listen, we are coming to the end of all things. Jesus Christ is coming back. The question is, are you ready? If you die today, do you know beyond a shadow of a doubt that heaven will be your home? If you don't, I'm talking to you. Well, Pastor, I hope I'll go to heaven. No, it's not a hope so. 1 John said, these things are written that you may know you have eternal life. So I want to introduce you to Jesus today. The simple plan of salvation is not deep, it is not hard. Simply, we were sinners. We couldn't do nothing about our sin. And so the Father had to send us Jesus because he loved us to deal with the sin problem. He came to earth and he lived as a man, but he lived a sinless life so he could give us his righteousness. He took on our unrighteousness and gave us his righteousness. So how do I receive this Jesus? Simply that, you got to receive him. He's a gift. You got to ask him to come into your heart because he's a real gentleman. And some of you, you go to church, but you're not really saved. Come on and commit to the Lord today. He needs you to make a commitment to him today. So simply pray this prayer with me. Those in the sanctuary, join me. Lift one hand towards heaven. Say, Lord Jesus, come into my heart and save me. I realize and I admit that I am a sinner, but I want to be saved by grace. And on today, I invite Jesus Christ into my heart. And I believe that he's taking care of all of my sins. In the past, in the present, and in the future. And on today, January 10th, 2021, I now make Jesus Christ my personal Lord and Savior. Thank you for saving me. Now I ask you, Jesus, to fill me with your presence. In Jesus' name. Amen. Well, my brothers and sisters, if you pray that prayer, come on, put your hands down and say, welcome. walk by faith and not by sight. So if you just prayed that prayer, why don't you send us a text? Text us your name, first and last name, and send us your email address. Send it to 601-618-8283, and we're going to bless you with this, the PDF of this book. PDF of this book. 601-618-8283. Amen? Amen? Glory to God. It's our free gift to you. We do still have our two books on sale, Redeemed from the Curse of Poverty, Sickness, and Spiritual Death, as well as Healing Belongs to You. Every member of this church, if you get those books and read them, it will open your eyes. Now, let's soak into the word we heard. I want our church to know we're having Increase Sunday on the second Sunday in March 2021. Well, we're going to come. We're believing. We're going into our new building. We're going to believe we're going into it debt-free in Jesus' name. We can do it right here because God is God everywhere. He's God in Atlanta. He's God in PG. So there are five ways for you to give this morning. You can give by going in person. That's for our members. You know where to go. You know what time to give. And then you can also give by text to give. 601-368-8909. 601-368-8909. Text the word GIVE to 601-368-8909. If you would like to sow a seed, doesn't matter, $2, $1, $3, into our coat drive. You can sow into our coat drive by simply going to our Cash App. Okay? Now that's only for the coat drive. It's $ New Covenant City Church. Okay? You can also give tithes, offerings, and gifts of love. You can give them by going to our website, www.newcovenantcity.org. Click on the giving tab and follow the instructions. It's safe and secure. Let me speak over your seed right now in Jesus' name. Father, we thank you for seed to sow into good ground. That is the New Covenant City Church. And as a result of our sowing, a great big harvest of fruit is coming forth from it. We thank you that thousands are getting saved as a result of this ministry. Marriages are being restored. Bodies are being healed. People are getting their needs met because we are the hands, arms, and feet of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, Father God, we thank you that as we sow our seed into this anointed ground, we call forth our supernatural harvest. Now, our motive is not to get a harvest, but our motive is we give because we love it, but we have a right to expect the harvest to come up. No man plants a seed and don't expect the harvest. So we expect seed time and harvest to start working in our life right now. But we thank you that we're consistent in our giving, we're consistent in our tithing, and we declare this church is a 100% tithing church. In Jesus' name, amen. Listen. I love you all so much. You already know on Communion Sunday, we're going to go over a little bit. I love you so much. Pray for me. Pray for our church. Let's pray for each other. Our intercessory prayer team prays every Wednesday at 8 p.m. Amen. 8:30 p.m. Every Wednesday, we are a praying church. Where there is no prayer, there will be no anointing. Okay, amen? So listen, we love you. Join me on Tuesday. I'm praying about what I should minister on Tuesday. There's some things that have come up in the country, and I want to know if the Lord wants me to address it. Whatever you do, don't miss Tuesday night. So if the Lord, whether I preach on that or expose the spirit of competitive jealousy, it's still going to be good. But pray for me because I don't want to minister out of hate. I don't want to minister out of my flesh. I don't want to minister out of strife. I want to minister out of the love of God, but I also want to minister truth. Wherever the Holy Spirit is, he is the spirit of truth. He's always going to expose the truth. Amen? So listen, I love you so much. Go have a good day on purpose. I'm going to have a wonderful day. I'm going to my Starbucks on my way to the house. I'm going to have a great day in Jesus' name. Listen, and all you're getting, get understanding, and Jesus is.